Now that you know about the different states in the activity lifecycle, how do you tell the system that you want to know about certain transitions? So for example, you probably only want to show an animation on the screen if the user is actively looking at your activity, and you want to stop that animation as soon as the screen is not visible anymore. Well, similar to click handling, the system will signal to you that a lifecycle transition is happening via a method callback, and each of the transitions gets its own callback. So using these callbacks, it gives you as a developer an opportunity to intervene and execute statements, so things like restoring or saving any data, or even cleaning up references that you no longer need at the moments that you need them. So here I am in the numbers activity. And you may have noticed that we've been writing the majority of our code in the activity's onCreate method. So this is the callback that the system executes once it has created your activity. And thus, by overwriting the method in your class definition, you're able to specify what you want to happen during that stage. Also, this is where we inflate our layout XML resources, obtain references to the view that we want to manipulate, and initialize any other crucial objects that our app relies on to function. Now in the Android developer documentation, if we look at the activity class, it shows all the system callbacks for the various states of the activity lifecycle. So you can override any of these methods within your activity class if you want to execute some code when the activity transitions into a particular state.